All right, that was Mr. Jim Kellum. My mic was off and you didn't hear that, but one more time, Jim Kellum. And your programs, if you look at your program, we got to make a change here. So I would ask you to just look at that. And we have, at this time, 7 o'clock sharp, we had the Grand Prairie Police Department Honor Guard, and they could not, circumstances could not make it, okay? So in that place, I have a replacement here that I think will do a great job. And so, Miss Lila and Mr. Brandon. Lila Thorne is one of the officers for the Lifeline Family Ministries. And I'm going to ask her if she would at this time to come and ask everybody if you would. She's going to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance, and I want to ask all of you, if you would, please, to stand with us and remain standing.
Thank you, Larry. We're sorry that the Honor Guard couldn't be here, but you know, duty calls, and their first calling is to protect us and our city, and for that we are most grateful. But we do have a representation of the police department that you'll hear in just a couple minutes. So I think that it would be very fitting and proper for us to give a round of applause for our first responders, our police department, our fire department, and our people in uniform. And now, if you will, please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance.
Mr. Brandon Poor.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
All right. Well, we're ready to get this thing started tonight. Remain standing, please, and I'm going to get you to sing, and it's not in your program. I'm going to get you to, there might be a lot of things tonight takes place. Beg your pardon? Oh, yeah. Come over here, Lynn. That wasn't in the program either. All right. Brother Lovelace called in sick this afternoon. He cannot be here, pastor of our church here at Calvary. And so our board of directors, head of board of directors, and our
chairman of the board of trustees.
You heard it first here.
I sang in Larry's choir for almost 30 years. Well, let me, I don't have, I have no talent. I didn't actually sing, I just showed up. Isn't that right, Larry?
Yeah.
We made it. We made it. All right, but this is Lynn Motley.
We want to welcome you all to Calvary. This has always been such a special time for us up here. Brian couldn't be here tonight. He's kind of been a little bit under the weather all week, and he's going to have a crowd, I hope, this big for tomorrow morning. And so he felt like he'd better stay in tonight. But again, we want to thank all of you for being here. It's a special night. Lifeline is such a special thing in Grand Prairie. This church has supported Lifeline with contributions each month and of course, this concert each year now for many years, and it's really our honor to do so. We're glad you're all here. We know this will be a special night as we sing the songs of Zion. And before we do, let's just go to the Word. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, for tonight, thank you for this group of people that have come. Thank you for those that every day work for Lifeline to help those that are homeless. Lord, we pray that you would continue to be a blessing to each one of them. And now, Lord, tonight, we pray as these songs are sung that your words would go out from this place throughout all of Grand Prairie. And Lord, the world would be changed by it. Thank you, Lord, for all that we have in Christ Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Well, it's not in the program, but I'll tell you what, it's been a tradition here with this conference or this concert, and I want you to join in with me. I want you to smile. I want you to sing. I want you to get warmed up, and let's sing it together. Something like this. Come on. Some glad morning when this life is o'er, I'll fly away on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away, I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Just a few more weary days, and then I'll fly away to a land where joy shall never end. I'll fly away. Come on now. I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, glory, I'll fly away. And all the people said, all right, thank you, and you may be seated. Several months ago, I got a phone call from Joel Salazar, music director of First Baptist Church here in the city. And he said, Larry, he said, let's talk over something. So we met and we talked over the fact that why don't we combine some choirs here at for the concert? And I said, man, you've got it. And I said, but you have got it. And so I'm good at putting things off for other people to do. And so Joel Salazar right here, let's give him a hand, please. First Baptist Church, Calvary Baptist Church, and our music director is in Florida attending a wedding. And so he won't be back until about 8 o'clock in the morning. And he'll be here ready to go, you know, bright-eyed and bushy-tailed for the service. And then over here, stand up over there, Mr. Aaron. This is Aaron. What's the last name, Aaron? I can't. Lifeline. And I don't have my program here. So he's the music director at Inglewood Baptist Church. Would you give him a hand? And then music director at First United Methodist Church, and I know she's up here. She is. Wave your hand real high. That's Nolene Pittman. Let's give her a hand. All right. Well, I think you're going to enjoy it, so I'm going to sit down and let this choir sing. And there he is, yeah. This is Mr. Perry Crenshaw. Let's give him a hand. Okay, folks, Jesus, the light of the world.
Thank you.
You're in for another treat. Here we go, right over here. He's over here in the side wings. Here we are. Mr. No stranger to you folks that have been coming every year. And this is Mr. Stuart Matthews. Let's give him a hand and make him feel welcome tonight.
Well, there's one thing that I know for sure. There's one thing I know for sure, and that's Jesus is coming back. Amen. And another thing that I might know is that if Jesus was going to sing a Toby Keith song, it might sound a little bit like this. Oh, the last time I came to her, a baby of a virgin birth, a world of rejection, no room in the inn. The Son of God in flesh and bone, opposite my heavenly throne, I came to this world to seek and to save. This cruel world was deaf to my call for repentance, caught up in its wicked ways. Declining my offer of heavenly deliverance, this world sent me to the cross. Well, how do you like me now? Yeah, how do you like me now? Now the King of Kings, do you still think I'm useless standing here today? I couldn't make you love me, but I rose up from the dead, offering salvation. How do you like me now?
It's okay to clap your hands.
Oh, now alive I'm up above, calling with my word of love, hoping you'll answer my call to be saved. You're wrapped up in your busy life, serving self and battling strife. Satan steals your hope and tears you apart. He leads you astray, but there's coming a day, a reckoning when all will be right. This old world is passing, my angels they're amassing. Don't miss it, it'll be the final call. Well, how do you like me now? Yeah, how do you like me now? Now that I'm King of Kings, do you still think I'm useless standing here today? I couldn't make you love me, but I rose up from the dead, offering salvation. How do you like me now?
Oh, you know, when he comes again, he's not coming as a little baby, oh no. He's coming as the mighty King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Every knee is going to bow. You want to make sure you're on the right side, amen, because when he comes again, he might be saying it a little bit like this.
Oh, how do you like me now? Now that I'm King of Kings, do you still think I'm useless standing here today? I couldn't make you love me, but I rose up from the dead, offering salvation. How do you like me now?
Oh, you know, he's saying, trust me now, child, I will save you.
Thank you, Mr. Stuart Matthews. Did I do that right? Did I call you Stuart Williams a while ago? Not yet. Okay. Well, we had a real treat for in store for you tonight. I had the governor of the state of Texas supposed to come and sing for us tonight. Greg Abbott. Well, he couldn't make it. So he sent a state representative in his place. Our own Mr. Rodney Anderson.
Thank you, Larry. All right. it is dangerous when you give a politician a microphone in front of this many people. Because normally what we do is, what do we start doing? We start shaking you down for money, right? That's what we typically do. But tonight we are raising money for Lifeline Shelter. And that, I want everyone to remember that. I look out there tonight, we've got a good crowd here tonight. So we should raise a record amount of money tonight. We should raise a record amount of money. And when I say that, I'm going to give you a small story that really hit me. I've got kids in the school district. I've got a sister-in-law who teaches in the school district. I was talking to some of the other teachers in the school the other day, and I was told in one classroom there are three homeless children. In a third grade classroom, there are three homeless children. This is in some of the school, in one of the schools. You would never think that would be possible. In one classroom, in another third grade classroom, two, so five in one classroom. And I can tell you, I am really proud tonight, and I don't know if they're going to introduce, but I've got my, he's going to shoot me when I'm over, but I've got a junior in high school over here that's playing in the orchestra over here. And I know at South Grand Prairie High School, we have this problem. I know it because I've seen it. I've talked with people who have risen above it thanks to Lifeline Shelter. And I will tell you that some of those, when you look around this room, you may not know they're there, but I know they're there, and their story is an inspiration. So if you were going to give $10, give $20. If you're going to give $20, give $40. If you're going to give $50, give $100. I'm telling you, folks, what Lifeline Shelter does, what they do, is what I'm going to sing about today. That when our children look through what we've left behind, may they find us faithful. That's what I'm singing about tonight. Find us faithful.
Journey of a narrow road, and those who've gone before us line the way, cheering on the faithful, encouraging the weary. Their lives a stirring testament to God's sustaining grace. Surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us run the race, not only for the prize, but as those who've gone before us, let us leave to those behind us the heritage of faithfulness passed on through godly love. Our children sift through all we've left behind. May the clues that they discover and the memories they uncover become the light that leads them to the road we each must find. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful.
the lives we live inspire them to obey. Obey all who come behind us, find us faithful. May the fire of our devotion light their way. May the footprints that we leave lead them to believe, and the lives we live inspire them to obey. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful.
Rodney Anderson, ladies and gentlemen. When you start talking and he's talking, you know, you don't give a politician a mic, you know, for in a crowd like this. I started to tell him, yeah, but Rodney, the man up there controls the sound. Had to do that. Well, I'll tell you what, you're in for a store. For a real blessing tonight. This lady right here thrills my soul deep, deep, deep down. And she's going to just bless your heart. I tell you for sure. Accompanied by Jim Kellum. Let's make welcome tonight Elizabeth Roney. Over here.
Discouraged, and why must a shadow come? Why must my heart be lonely and long for heaven and home when Jesus is my portion? A constant friend is he, for his eye is on the watches me. I sing because I'm happy. Sparrow, and watches me. I sing because I'm so happy. Oh, yes, I sing because I'm free.
Roney. Her mother and her sister. Is that your other sister? That's your her two sisters and her mother are here. Oh, that's a daughter. She's with them. Would you stand over here? They bless my heart. I watch them in the audience every time. Come on, stand over here. Let these people see you, make you feel welcome. All right. One of these days, we'll have all three of them sing for you. Yeah. Well, we got a young man coming to us at this time. This is his first time on this platform. Well, not on this platform. He grew up on this platform. And he's over in Arlington now. And he will bless your heart. I want you to make welcome tonight, Mr. Josh Yancy. Josh?
We will sing, holy, holy.
people up in the radio room and everything, I'll say this. If that don't light your fire, your wood's all wet. I did it. All right. Josh Yancy, he does a great job. Great job. He'll be back on later on in the program. Well, come on. This is our First United Methodist Church Quartet. And they just did a great job for us last year. And so they're back this year. And they're going to get their mics. And I'm going to get out of the way. Let's make them feel welcome, would you please? Here we go. Touched me and made me whole. Thank you, Quartet. You did a great job. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All right. You having fun tonight? All right. Well, this guy coming up on the platform over my left over here probably doesn't need much introduction to anybody. It's been about how many? He hasn't been able to be with us, what, 2 years?
2 years.
2 years, and he's back here tonight, and he's going to thrill your heart also. Grew up here at Calvary. I taught him everything he knows.
Did.
I didn't teach him everything I know, but I taught him everything he knows. And, well, I'll tell you, he was a blessing to us there, and has still is here at Calvary. And I've asked Scott Thornton to come be with us tonight. And you know Scott, so let's give him a good round of applause.
from up. Though sometimes my soul gets weary and I long to rest a while, but my heart is set on heaven. My strength is yours alone. This may not be my last step, but I'm that much closer home here today. I see my earthly treasures, and nothing can compare to the splendor or the glory that's waiting over there here today. Flesh and bones, I'll sail away from earthly sorrow here today, but tomorrow I'll be
be back here after a while. Well, I tell you, I miss one individual. You should sit down here about the third row right there. And Mr. Jackson. He was a boy, I tell you what, if you couldn't sing with him sitting in an audience, you just can't sing. And he would sit down here, he was blind. And there was a song that touched his heart every year, every year. I'd always sing it just to see the reaction from him. We'd sing the chorus of that song that the quartet sang just a moment ago. We'd sing the chorus, "He Touched Me." Oh, what joy that fills my soul. And he would sit there blind, but that old head thrown back, big old tears coursed down his cheeks. Boy, he's up there singing tonight. I'll tell you. Let's sing it, would you? He touched me. Oh, he touched me. And all the joy that floods my soul. Something. And that floods my soul. Something happened and now I know. He touched me and made me whole. Now you sing good. May I introduce to you over here at the piano is Woody Cash and Jim Kellum on the keyboard. Make them both appreciate, show your appreciation. They do a great job. Well, you getting ready, Olin?
I'm getting ready.
Okay. There goes the coat. That's ready enough now. Let's don't go any further. Come get your mic here. Yes, yes. The choir and Olin Massey. Make them feel at home. Come on.
Woo! Wow, good. Let's sing it now. When I talk on life's sea and the waves they cover me and the dark cloud won't let that sunshine. Then a voice seems to say, child, there'll be another day. Don't allow the storms to hide sweet heaven's view. Cause you've got
one more valley,
one more hill. And you've got
one more trial,
one more. Let Satan see your tears. Learn to smile away your fears. Hold your head up high and let the sun shine through. Just be grateful always. It'll be over all someday. For yes, it all will be over after a while.
Everybody stand, please. Let's sing along.
One more hill.
Just one more.
It's right here. Come on.
One more trial. One more tear.
Just one more tear. One more curve. And life grows. One more mile. Left to go.
And you can lay down your heavy load when you get old.
One more hill,
just one more hill.
and you can lay down your heavy load when you get home.
Lay it down, Larry. Lay it down. Hold on.
Hold on. Hold on, Massey, in the choir. Choir. Thank you, and you may be seated. Let me see. I'm looking for my ladies. Oh, here she is. Okay. I thought you were over there. Do you? Always come from here. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome tonight Miss Gail Wills. I was going to say Willis. I meant Wills. Miss Gail Wills from the Lifeline for Family. Would you make her welcome?
All right. Good evening. Thank you so much for coming again this evening. Some of you have been here already once this year in March. But now we're here again in September, and I'm so glad that you came. Rodney's right about the surprising aspect of homelessness in our very own community. And I'm startled, and yet I've been associated with Lifeline for many years. But 12 years ago, when Angela founded Lifeline, the need was great, and the need is still great, unfortunately. But thanks to y'all, we can really step in and make a difference. Lifeline was founded, as I said, 12 years ago, and during that time, thousands of families have actually been helped and removed from homelessness. So I ask you this evening to open up your wallets and your checkbooks and, I don't know, even your credit card. Someone's bound to have a square here. And we will raise a lot of money that will help a lot of people. If there's anyone from our, well, I know we have at least one city council member here tonight, and Lila's in the back. There may be others. George is moving. Do we have any school board members tonight? Yay, we do. Thank you for coming. And would the members of the board of directors of Lifeline please stand and be recognized as well, or wave your hands. You don't have to stand if you don't want to, but we've got several. Appreciate your service. And thank you so much for the churches and the choirs who've sung tonight. It's just been very warming. I thank you very much.
All right. Lynn? No. Come here. Mr. Lynn Motley.
Same choir director, too. Okay, show me the envelopes. Surely you have your envelopes, right? Now look, we need for you to put something in the envelope, okay? That's important. That's very important. Think of all the people that this is going to help. There are going to be a lot of them. Rodney was right about this. I remember when I was on the school board in Grand Prairie. And that was a long time ago. But homelessness even then was a serious problem, and there was no Lifeline. And it was difficult. And it's difficult today for a lot of families. So please, this is the one opportunity you have perhaps this year to make a donation to a cause that you know can affect the lives of young people. I used to tell people when I was on the board that education is an investment in people's lives. It's an investment in Grand Prairie. And you have a way to make an investment today in the lives of young people in Grand Prairie, and I hope you'll do that. Please join me in prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you again for this night. Thank you for the opportunity to hear a great gospel song. And Lord, thank you for the opportunity to give, to make an investment in the lives of young people and families in Grand Prairie. Thank you for all the things that we have in Christ Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Sing that chorus if you would. Christ is all I need. Christ is all I need.
Christ is all I need.
All I need. Sing it again. While you do, choir, come on up, take your places. Christ is all I need. Come ahead, choir.
Christ is all I need. He's all I need.
Sing. Corrie ten Boom was appearing with Billy Graham's Crusade. Corrie ten Boom talked to Cliff Barrels one night. She said, Cliff, there's something wrong. He said, what? You know, Cliff Barrels and the Great Choir and Bev Shea. She said, let the people sing. I've never forgotten that. Let the people sing. You got a song in your heart, just like these folks up here do. You're just sitting up there, they're standing up here. Let the people sing. Well, Elizabeth, where are you? Come on. And here we go, Elizabeth Roney and the Lifeline Shelter singers and orchestra. Give him a hand. Sing a chorus. Roney, ladies and gentlemen, in the choir and the orchestra. All right, thank you, and you may be seated. Well, we saw one side of Olin a while ago. He's back, and I'm glad he is. Olin and I, we were talking last night. up here? Okay, I'm glad you're doing that. Well, I got one to match right over there. And there's a reason for it. We were talking last night and again this morning. Olin and I started singing together when we were both in the seventh grade over at the old Lee. Well, it wasn't Lee then, it was just junior high. Anybody in here go to junior high? That's what I thought. We started singing with Earl Tom Keel, seventh grade. Earl Tom Keel was a great director. Seventh, eighth, and ninth grade, we sang together. And then when we graduated from the ninth and went to Grand Prairie High, there was only school then. Only high school then. And we had Earl Tom for the next 3 years. We all graduated together. We've been singing. He went into evangelism, and I was here at Calvary Baptist for 34 years. And Olin has sung all over this country. And I told him the other night, I said, Olin, I said, did you ever stop to think that when we were in the seventh grade in the old Grenadiers, that we're both now 77 years old, that we'd be singing together still after all these years? I love this man. He's been a real inspiration to me down through these years, and I know he has been to you. And so, again, I want to bring to you Mr. Olin Massey, his accompanist. This is Miss Cheryl Meyers, right here at the piano.
You know, I Googled in my Bible and found out that over 1,500 times in the New Testament, there's a mention of the return of Christ. But you and I have something in common. We've talked about memories. We have more memories. I may have said this to you before. We have more memories in the past than we've had in the future. No, I said it backwards. We have more memories in the future than we've had in the past. We really do. 1,500 times, 188 times in Matthew. And it's been on my heart. It may be the only way this country, this world will survive. Come on down. Come on down. Come on down, Lord Jesus, and take us away. Come on down, Lord Jesus, could this be the day? Even so, come quickly, Lord Jesus, I pray. Come on down, Lord Jesus, come soon. He said, let not your heart be troubled. When hearts all around you fail, He's coming to take us. He'll never forsake us. Look up, He could come down today. Take us home, Lord Jesus, your church upward bring. Maranatha, the word that these lips long to sing. For I long to assemble before the great King. Come on down, Lord Jesus, come soon. The storehouse is filled beyond measure. This old world keeps spinning in time.
His blessings are on us, His word filled with promise. And one prayer filled this heart of mine. Come down, Lord Jesus, and take us away. Come down, Lord Jesus. Could this be the day? Even so, come quickly, Lord Jesus, I pray. Come on down. Come on down, Lord Jesus, come soon.
He's still got it, hasn't he? Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. I'll tell you for sure. Years ago, here in this auditorium, I had a young man who was 10 years old, and he came with his mom from down in Houston. He came here to sing. He was getting ready to start doing some traveling. He was 10 years old, had his first album, and he brought his album with him, you know, and sold them out there in the lobby. The next year, I had him again. He was 11, and he just brought the house, packed the house both times. And now he's written a song that all of you, I think, know and associate with. And he wrote a song called "Mary, Did You Know?" And that was Mark Lowry. I was privileged to have him when he was 10. I hope that we kind of gave him the encouragement to go on. Now he sings with the Gaither Vocal Band, and he's doing a great job. And I've asked Josh to come and sing for you one of my very favorite of all songs this time of the year, Christmas. "Mary, Did You Know?" Josh Yancy, let's give him a hand.
The praises of the Lamb. is Lord of all creation. Mary, did you know? Will one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? The sleeping child you're holding is the grave.
Let me let you know that out in the lobby after we finish the concert tonight, Josh has a CD out there he just made. He sent it to me, and I'm telling you, you'll enjoy it if you want to get a good CD. And he's on this side of the lobby over there. And over here on the left side of the lobby, Stuart Matthews has his CDs, and they're for sale, folks. Just go out there, and you can hear these guys the rest of the month. Year, whatever. All right. Next on our program, oh, by the way, I'm going to send Mark Lowry a copy of that. Let him hear Josh sing that. I want to let you know also that up in the room up here, they are filming all of this to be put on, is it Facebook? Facebook. Mark Prater. So you go on Facebook for Mark, and his name's on the back of your program there, Mark Prater, P-R-A-T-E-R, and all of this will be on Facebook. I'll have to get Kendall to teach me how to get on Facebook, but I want to watch it. And so anyway, do I see back there in the back, is that Brandon? Brandon? We had a cancellation. I got a call this afternoon from Bill Webb. He and his wife and daughter were supposed to sing tonight, and his wife has had back surgery, and she is really going through some complications at this time. So pray for Miss Webb, and she needs your prayers. And they just could not make it tonight. And I told him, I said, well, we'll have this group of people pray and put your wife on their hearts, and we'll just go right on down the road and have you next year. So he said, okay. So it brings us now to Brandon Poor. How'd you like a Star Spangled Banner? And he's going to sing for you now at this time, Great is Thy Faithfulness.
They fail not, as thou hast been, thou forever wilt be. Summer and winter and springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy, and love. faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Pardon for sin and a peace that endureth. Thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide. Strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Great
Brandon Poor.
Ooh, man, God bless you.
Oh, I'll tell you. And as old boy said, and I'll say it for the people up in the room, if that don't ring your bell, there's something wrong with your clanger. All right? Okay. Brandon, thank you so much, so much. Last night, he came up here, had a big old gun on his side. He's a detective for the Grand Prairie Police Department. And boy, I'll tell you what, yes. And if he doesn't shoot those guys, he can sing to them and make them surrender, you know? Powerful voice, powerful. Well, where is he? Coming right over here, mister. Here, I'll give you your mic. There you go. Let's welcome back Scott Thornton. Come on.
I was going to ask Brandon if I could borrow a couple of those low notes every once in a while. Then he hit those high notes. I need to borrow a couple of them high notes, too.
Me too, boy.
Wow. Very, very good, Brandon. Very
Everything
good.
Everything in between.
Yeah.
I could not go on without him, I know. This world would overwhelm my soul. I could not see the right way. Temptation for me. Oh, he whispers sweet peace to me. He whispers sweet peace to me. When I am cast down, troubled in soul, he whispers sweet peace.
in a still small voice we're told. It's a voice that dispels all our fears. And when I am cast down, troubled soul, it's that still small voice I hear. He whispers sweet peace to me. He whispers sweet peace to me. When I am cast down, trouble in my soul, he whispers sweet peace to me. When I am cast down, in trouble in my soul, he whispers sweet peace to me.
Thank you, Scott. Scott Tart. If you're ever out in Cleburne or Burleson? Burleson. You ever out in Burleson? He has a restaurant out there. Stop by, he'll feed you. Right? For free. We'll get a bus load and go over there. All right. Well, let me see. I don't have to see my program. Mr. Crenshaw. Let's make him welcome again.
Hey.
God bless you.
God bless you.
Do me a favor. Turn to your neighbor on the left or on the right and tell them, I really love the Lord.
I really love the Lord.
That didn't sound very convincing. Turn to the other neighbor on the other side and say, neighbor.
I really love the Lord.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
I really love the Lord.
Really love.
Now put your hands together. Let's give God some praise. If you really love him, come on. If you really love him, put your hands together. Let's give him some praise. I really love you. I really love you. Because you've heard of me. I really love you. Yes, I do. I really love you, Jesus. I really love you. Because you first love me, I really love you. Yes, I do. You think you can help me? I really love you. Yeah, really love you. Because you first love me, I really love you. Yes, I do. Listen to this. How can you love me knowing all the things I've done? And then you showed me when you gave your only son. Oh, I really love you. I really love you. Yes, I do. Oh, how can you love me knowing all the things I've done? And then you showed me when you gave your help me sing. I really love you. Oh, you're sounding good tonight. I can hear you, there you go. Because they sound pretty good. I really love you, yes I do. Listen to this. You are the air I breathe, yeah. You are the song I sing. No one can compare to all the joy you bring.
Thank you, Mr. Crenshaw. Crenshaw, y'all excuse me, but I got to bring this over here because I can't, my memory's not that good, and so I'm going to cheat. All right. I had a cancellation today, and that's middle of the afternoon, and my wife said, Larry, you're not on the program. And I told her, well, there's a reason for that. She said, no, there's not. So I got up here at the church, and Olin said, Larry, you're not on the program. I said, no, I'm not. He said, well, get on it. So if you'll bear with us tonight, when we do programs like this, I'm usually so worn out, and I probably will show it tonight. But they've asked me to sing. So I want to do like Olin. I want to take it easy here. And there's a song, like I said, Olin and I have been singing, goodness gracious, seventh grade. That's 63 years today. 63 years, and we've been singing and walking with the Lord and serving the Lord and music ministries. And we're getting old. We're getting a little worn out. And so ask Olin, would you do it again? If you could go back where you were then, would you do it all over again? The answer is yes. Just as long as I'm holding my dear Savior's hand, I'd do it again. I'd do it all over again. So they have this song that says that. And so they didn't know I was going to do this. I didn't know it either, but I hope we have the right words up here. If we're not, I've got a cheat sheet right here that'll just take good care of it. And so I'm going to use both if you don't mind. Next time I'll do it without cheat sheets. Song is entitled, I Do It All Over Again. I have walked through the valley of the shadow of death. I have breathed what surely would but as long as I'm holding my Savior's hand, oh, I tread all over again. I'd walk that same road if he walks with me far over and over he has proven to be my healer, redeemer, companion, and and as long as he's with me, I do it all over again. Light in my darkness when I felt so all alone, when my heart was heavy, he gave me a song. There were places he's led me I don't understand. Oh, but I do it all over again. I'd walk that same road if he walks with me far over, over and over he has proven to be my healer, my redeemer, my companion, and my friend, and I do it all over again. Again, he's my healer, my redeemer, he's my companion, and my friend. As he's with me, oh, as long as he's with me, I know I'd do it all over again. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You're kind. God's good. Olin, maybe you'll give us another 60 years or something like that. Thank you, and you may be seated. Well, choir, just come on up, and while you're coming up, I'm going to be doing something else. Ladies, can you come over here with me? Over there? Can y'all come over? While they're doing that, I would like to say tonight we were unable to put some people's names in our program because they did things after we had the program printed. But I have special recognition and thank you goes tonight to Dr. Susan Hall, the superintendent of Grand Prairie Independent School District, and her assistant Miss Amy France. Grand Prairie Independent School District. They loaned us these risers that are up on the right and on the left and brought a crew in here to set them up for us. And I appreciate that. Then down at the front, I needed to reserve some sections here for these choirs. And Dean Guerrero Funeral Home said, got it made. And they brought them up, and I thank them so much. I'm probably leaving somebody out somewhere. But they all helped make this possible tonight. Well, here we go. Before I do that, don't forget next year's 12th annual Lifeline Gospel Concert be held on Saturday night, September the 10th. It's a leap year. September the 10th, 2016. And so I'll get it put together, Alton. Just hang in there. I'll get it. All right. Well, let me have a drum roll. All right, here's the drum roll. I want the first number, right? No, the first number. Oh, you're going to do it backwards? Oh, yeah. Oh, the last number. What's the last number? Zero. And then the next number, two, zero. Next number, zero. And the next number, comma. And now a heavy drum roll, heavy drum roll. Number, zero, and a one. $10,020 you gave tonight. Thank you. Thank you, ladies. Thank you. Well, I tell you, that's great. That's great, 10,000. And then there's others I know that probably be sending checks in the next few days, months, or whatever, and adding to that. But that's a good start, I'll tell you. I would do like to say thank you to one other. The other day I got a phone call and people said, look, I saw on Facebook y'all are having this concert Saturday night at 12. We're going to come be there. We want to hear the concert. They live in Lubbock, Texas. And they left early this morning and drove 5 hours to be here so they could be here for the concert tonight. I'm going to embarrass them, but I'm going to ask Jan and Neil Christopher, right back here with my wife. Stand, would you? Come on. Anybody drive that far, I want to recognize them. Jen played piano for me for years. We traveled together on ensemble tours, and if I had room, I'd have put her on the program, but she has a bad foot. She was coming down here to see us couple months ago, and she got over here as far as Fort Worth, walked out in the yard, fell and broke her foot. She called me and they were heading back to Lubbock. They'd been here maybe 30 minutes, had to go all the way back, 5 hours. Well, choir, orchestra, our director, choir, and pianist over here, Miss Becky, this is his wife. Better half. All right. And I'm going to get out of the way and get these guys their mics. Joel Salazar. Stuart Williams. The choir. Orchestra. And all. What did I say? Alton, I'll be all right. Stuart Matthews. Because he lives.
God sent his son. They called him Jesus. He came to love, heal and forgive, and to think that he lived and died just to buy my. my part. Praise God, an empty grave is there, and it proves my Savior lives. Because He lives, I can face tomorrow. Because He lives, all fear is gone. Because I know He holds the future, and life is worth the living just because He lives. And then one day I'll cross that river. I'll find life's final. It's final war with pain.
And then as death gives way to victory, I'll see the lights of glory, and I'll know He reigns.
Everybody.
Thank you. Good night, and come again next year. God bless you.